Good morning students, this is Pawan, your science master. Students, this video is for 5th standard students. Students, what we have been talking, did you remember name of the chapter? There are two students sitting beside me, I would like to ask them. Shashi and Charan. Shashi, you tell me. What is the name of the chapter?
Air and water.
Air and water. Charan, tell me the name of the chapter.
Air and water.
Air and water. And what are the properties of air?
Air has weight.
Very good.
Air occupies space.
And what else, Charan?
Air exerts pressure.
Very good.
Air is useful for breathing.
Air is useful for breathing. Nice. Very good. Air exerts pressure and air is useful for breathing as well. Okay, got it. And what are the other properties? You know, what do you say?
The air has pressure.
Air has pressure. That already Charan said. Okay.
Air has weight.
Air has weight.
Air occupies space.
Air occupies space. Nice. So these are the properties that air possesses. That means air has. And we have talked about activities based on these properties to prove these properties that air possesses. We have talked about different activities like, you know, the images that you can see on the screen. You know, first activity one, air occupies space and air has weight, air exerts pressure and air is needed for breathing as well. Okay, nice. Now, and also we have talked about air and its uses. Air is needed for breathing, air carries information, and air pressure is important in daily life. To prove that how air pressure is important in our daily life, the activity 5 makes us to understand. I have explained this and you please see the previous videos. Okay, and especially in this video what I'm going to talk to you is air pollution. Students, I go on reading and explain, you please try to understand. Air pollution. Students, repeat after me, what concept are we going to talk here?
Air pollution.
Air pollution. Say.
Air pollution.
Air pollution.
Both of you same at the same time, you should say. What are we going to talk here?
Air pollution.
Say once again.
Air pollution.
Once again.
Air pollution.
Air pollution. Right. See, air is a precious resource. Resource in the sense it is available. The availability. It's a resource available in the nature. So that we can say air is a natural resource. So it's available in abundant. Abundantly in the sense in huge quantities. Air is available in huge quantities. Okay. That complete earth is covered by air. Students, you can see the previous videos I have talked about what is air and where is air present. Air is present everywhere. Okay. Right. Next, without air, the earth will be cold, dry, silent and lifeless. Okay. Here, without air, the earth will be cold, dry, silent and lifeless. Shashi, tell me, without air, how the earth will be?
Cold.
Cold.
Cold and lifeless.
Cold, lifeless.
Dry.
Dry and
silent.
Yes. To carry the information, what I'm talking here, you are able to listen, right? What is there between both of us? No, air is there. The information is carried by whom?
Air.
Air. I am talking and you are able to listen. The sound that I am talking, you are able to listen, right? You are able to respond, right? So who is carrying this sound to your ears?
Air.
Air is carrying. Yes, you are right. So if there is no air, if I talk here, you cannot listen my voice here. Okay, if there is no air, we cannot hear the sounds that are around us. That earth will be very silent and there will be no life. So the earth will remain lifeless without air on it. Okay, that you remember. Okay, man is contaminating the air by releasing unwanted poisonous gases from factories, power stations and exhausts of vehicles. Okay, yeah, man is contaminating means man is polluting, making it impure. Okay, do you think we are breathing pure air, fresh air?
No.
No. Why?
Man is.
Yes, contaminating it.
Contaminating.
How man is contaminating air?
By releasing.
Very good.
Necessary gases.
Huh?
Necessary gases.
By releasing unnecessary gases, not necessary gases. By releasing unnecessary or unwanted, that too poisonous. Okay, that too. Poisonous gases from factories
and
power stations and exhausts of vehicles. Okay,
exhausts of
what?
Vehicles.
Exhausts of what?
Vehicles.
Yes, you're right. And this contamination of air with undesirable things is called what?
Air pollution.
Very good. Air pollution. Right. This contamination of air with undesirable things is called
air pollution.
You focus on the concept that what I am talking. Okay. If you think something else, you cannot answer to the question that I ask here. Okay. You focus on that what I am talking. You too. Focus on that what I am talking. Okay. Right. Next. Breathing in polluted air can cause diseases like asthma, bronchitis, etc. What is asthma? It's a disease related to which part of our body?
Respiratory system.
Yes, lungs. You're right. You said lungs, right? Okay, right. Lungs also right. Respiratory system. Okay, next. Even the bronchitis is the word related to respiratory system. Okay, the disease is caused to respiratory system is called bronchitis. What is bronchitis?
The disease caused to respiratory system.
Yes, the disease is caused to
respiratory system
are called bronchitis and asthma. Asthma and bronchitis, the disease is caused by air that we are breathing. Polluted air. Fresh air or polluted air?
Polluted air.
If we breathe polluted air, we are getting that kind of diseases like asthma and bronchitis, etc. So, is this good? Breathing impure air or, you know, polluted air or contaminated air is good or bad?
Bad.
So, what should we do? We should stop polluting the air. Stop contaminating the air. Okay, we should stop contaminating the air. How is it getting polluted? How is it getting contaminated? Tell me, how is it getting polluted?
By factories,
industries, power stations,
exhausts
of vehicles. Okay, so here what we have to do, we have to stop polluting by following some precautions. What is precaution? Okay, what is precaution? See, not to happen before it happens.
It is prevention.
What I said?
See, precaution.
Precautions or prevention are same, okay?
See, not to happen before it happens.
Very good. We should see not to happen before it happens, you know. We are experiencing, you know, with some diseases caused by air pollution, no? So, we should see that not to happen before it happens for the people, those who are healthy right now. So we see some people are suffering from this kind of diseases like asthma and bronchitis, right? Then we are healthy, of course. We may also get the same diseases by breathing
polluted air.
So we should see that not to happen that. So we should take some precautions or preventions. Okay, right? So, what sort of precautions should be taken? Let us see here. I will read and explain. You see, prevention of air pollution. What are we talking now?
Prevention of air pollution.
Prevention of air pollution. See, car engines should be designed to produce less pollution. You know, car engines, not only car engines,
ma. Bike engines also.
Engines, bike engines you take, bus engines you take, any vehicle, any automobile engine, you know, should be designed to produce less pollution. Next, lead-free petrol should be used in vehicles. Lead-free petrol should be, that releases very less pollutants into air. That also used to prevent the air pollution. Okay. Next, factories should use filters in chimneys before releasing the fumes into the air. Factories should use what? Filters. Factories should use what?
Filters.
Filters. What? Filters in
chimneys.
Chimneys. Chimneys are the long constructions which help to pass out what?
Gas.
Fumes out. Okay, gas out. Okay, the smoke out. Right? Factories should use filters in chimneys before releasing the fumes into the air. Got it? So these are the precautionary measures for what? Air pollution. Precautions of
air pollution.
So if we follow these measures, then we can reduce air pollution. That's for this video, students, and I hope you all understood these points. I want you to write what is air pollution and what are the precautions or prevention of air pollution points, you know, that I want you to write in your notes and present it in our WhatsApp group. And also, I would like to teach you about water in the next class. Okay, it's better if you read it and be ready for listening this video. And this is for this video. Thank you for listening, and thank you one and all. Thank you.